The information shared this afternoon is very important for many reasons. We're going to be talking about industry in Hart County and what is out there and what the reason this is only 9th to 11th is because obviously seniors are about to graduate. But we're going to be talking about the different opportunities that you can have with our partnership with our College and Career Academy. Opportunities that are in this community to make very good money. Very good money. And so some of this you may know, some of your parents actually may work in some of these industries. But I think a lot of this information will be out of me, not only to our students, but our teachers as well. Because there's things that we're going to be doing in the College and Career Academy that's going to open up some doors for many of you if you, choose to do that. Whether it's the idea that you want to go directly to work after school when you get out, when you graduate, or whether you want to go on to college and pursue some field. Okay? Dwayne Dye, he's going to be speaking to you. He's the Director of Economic Development for Hart County. So he is a big player when it comes to industry in this community and the things that move here. And the latest one that you probably heard about is Herring. It's moving here, bringing a lot of jobs to our community. A lot of opportunities there, making very good money. Okay? So I want you to give your undivided attention during this time period. We will dismiss from here when it's time. But I think it's very important that you see what's here. Okay, I had no clue that there was a local industry that had a robot that cost $2 million operating every day. I didn't know that. And there's things that you're going to learn here that you probably didn't know as well. Okay? Because I think you'll come away with, wow, there's a lot of opportunity in Hart County. Not only for you, but for your family. Okay, so this time, I'm going to introduce you to Dwayne Dye. Good afternoon. Okay, so we don't have seniors in here with us today. Where's my juniors? Where's the 11th grade? All right, sophomores. Freshmen. All right, we got some 9th grade in here too, don't we? All right, wonderful. Well, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for allowing me to be here. And I say ladies and gentlemen because you are the future. You are, ladies and gentlemen, you are the ones that are going to be the future, not only for Hart County, but for Georgia and for our country. So some of you may have heard the old adage that time waits for no man, and that's the truth. So what I'm going to tell you today is the future belongs to you. That's the good news. Bad news is it's ready or not, here I come. Future belongs to you. Now, some of you may already have your minds made up. You know exactly what you're going to do. You know what your career path is. You've got everything nailed down. And if you're in that boat, you're in a lot better shape than I was. So what I wanted to do is to come out today, not to try to steer you in any particular direction, but what I want to do is to give you options, give you some information about what's available right here in your community. So the thing I can say first is I've been involved in economic development since 2006. And Hart County students, teachers, faculty have a lot to be proud of because over this same time period, Hart County students, the teachers, the administration here have brought our high school graduation rate up from about 64.5% to around 95%. And that's all been done in a period of about 10 to 11 years. So you have a lot to be proud of. The grad dog that you saw up here, that was developed by Hart County students. The videos that you're going to see in a little bit were done by Hart County students, by your peers. Very professional job. You guys have done a great job. And the future really does belong to you. You can make whatever you want of yourself. It doesn't matter what socioeconomic background that you came from, red, yellow, black, white, male, or female. It doesn't matter. What I'm going to show you today are opportunities that each and every one of you can do. Over the last 10 years, we've brought in nearly 3,400 new advanced manufacturing jobs. Now you ask me, what is an advanced manufacturing compared to regular manufacturing? Advanced manufacturing has a technical component. Each and every one of you can take out your iPhone or whatever, Galaxy, whatever it is that you guys carry, and you can run circles around me because the technology you guys are used to using it every day. I'm not, I'm old school, so you already have an advantage over me. Most of these 3,400 jobs that have been brought in have a technical component. CNC you're gonna hear, which is computer numerical control. The other is PLC, which is programmable logic controllers. if you can write script, if you can write some code for a computer, you can do these jobs. These companies have brought in over $400 million to our community over the past 10 years. So people are investing heavily in Hart County. The manufacturing operations that we have here are safe. They're safe working environments. They take a lot of pride in having a safe environment. They don't want anybody to get hurt. They're clean. Most of these operations, you can go in, you can eat off the floor. They are team-oriented. You don't have a lot of supervision walking around that day. It's team-oriented, so you can work with your peers to come up with answers and solve problems. And it's right here in your backyard, which means that when you get ready to graduate, the only reason for you to move away from Hart County is if you want to. Now, some people do. I've been around. I worked with Johnson & Johnson for 24 years. I had a chance to see most of the world. I'm glad I had a chance to see it. Having seen it, I can tell you that there is no place more beautiful, people more friendly, or a better place to raise a family than Hart County, Georgia. And that is the truth. And if you don't believe me, come back 10 years after you graduate and have a chance to see the rest of the world. All right, what I'd like to do is to take a quick break here and show you a couple of videos. I'm not sure how many of you have already seen these. But these are two videos that have just recently been produced to spotlight some of our industry here.
Jobs in Hart County continue to evolve as many new industries move into the Northeast Georgia community. SD Automotive is located in the industrial park just off of US 29 in Hart County. Founded over 30 years ago as a modeling building company in Germany, SD Automotive has become specialists in making tools and prototypes and are proud of their innovative automotive technology. To better serve their US customers, SD Automotive opened their first US facility in Hartwell. The multi-million dollar business now provides jobs for the skilled workforce of Hart County, including many of which pay as much as $20 per hour. With the ever-changing world of cars and trucks, SD Automotive continues to use the latest in CNC machinery, laser cutting technology, and CAD designing to develop the future of the automobile industry. For more information about SD Automotive, be sure to visit sdautomotive-group.us.
Okay, so that one's a little German toolmaker that located here about 8 years ago, and they run a software that the only other people in the United States that run it is Boeing. They use it to make aircraft. That's how advanced it is.
Founded in 1992, Fabritex is a family-owned and operated Hart County industry that emphasizes tube fabrication and sheet and plate fabrication. With clients such as the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, Fabritex's reach spans the globe. Fabritex employees span the spectrum of manufacturing jobs, including welding, CNC fabrication, laser technology, engineering technology, and much, much more. In 2008, Fabritex was the second manufacturing plant in the state of Georgia to be 100% certified work-ready. That leadership and readiness to employ the citizens of Hart County continues as a part of the multi-million dollar business here in Hart County. For more information about Fabritex, be sure to visit Fabritex.com.
Okay, so give you a little bit of an idea of exactly what kind of industry is here, because a lot of adults don't know what's here. How many people knew that pure pharmaceuticals, prescription medications are made in Hart County? Medical devices, OTC, which is over-the-counter drugs, consumer products, lots and lots of automotive, from Tenneco to TI Automotive to SD Automotive to Herring that's coming in. This is a lot of automotive suppliers. Conveyor belt manufacturing, computerized energy management systems, metalworks, from basic welding all the way up to CNC operations, mining, open pit mining, and oilseed plant, which benefits a lot of our farmers here that produce canola and sunflowers that are produced into oil. The skills required to do these jobs, CNC is computer numerical control, PLC is programmable logic controllers. You got to have computer skills to do this. But if you got computer skills, I'm going to show you some of the money you can make here in just a little bit with these. Electrical, hydraulics, mechanics, if you can do these, it doesn't matter, male or female. There's no heavy lifting in these jobs anymore. Metallurgical, learning how to treat steel, how to make it behave a certain way, how to harden it, how to do certain things with steel. All the way to welding, these are skills that are badly needed. I don't see us filling all these jobs with our county folks. We're going to have people come in. Automotive, mechanical, electrical, diesel. Information technology is a booming and going to be a continually booming industry, as is the quality control area. Engineering, supervisory from HR, human resources, all the way up to the CEO of the plant, sales and marketing, and then soft skills I've got at the bottom, because soft skills are extremely important. You'd just be surprised how many folks my age don't know how to show up every day for work on time, dressed appropriately for their work. It's a shame. If you can do that, you got to beat already. And when to use, when and when not to use cell phones and social media, that's getting a lot of people in trouble. So let me show you a little bit about the other skills, the descriptions, and the wage ranges. We talked about SD Automotive and some of the others that do metalwork, tool making. The wage ranges on those, now you're not going to go in making over $38 an hour because you don't know the skills, you don't have the experience when you go in. But the starting pay for many of these is above $16 an hour. By the time you get up to the top pay, you're making $80,000 plus a year. Anything above this line can be done with your technical college certificate that you can get either from Athens Technical College or from the College and Career Academy once it opens. You do not need to go to 4 years of college for this. Industrial mechanical, same thing. You see the wage rates there. Transportation trucking, truck drivers can make $50,000 or more a year. CNC, we talked about a little while ago. Operators and programmers can make around $60,000 a year once you get to top pay. Below the line, typically you're going to have to go to a four-year college, complete a degree in this area here, quality control, or CQE, which is a certified quality engineer, makes around $79,000 in top pay, sales and marketing, information systems, engineering, and ME is mechanical, EE is electrical and chemical engineers. Then the managers and CEOs, you can top out above $200,000. In this area. But again, you're not going to do that day one. You've got to, you've got to put in your time and get the experience in addition to your education. All this is official data from the Georgia Department of Labor for 2016. Some of you that are interested in healthcare, these are your pay rates for radiology, nursing, occupational therapy, physical therapy. Now, I'm going to try to put this to you in terms that you can understand. You see the house here at the bottom, and the car here at the bottom. This is real information that I just pulled. This is current. This house, unless it's sold in the last 2 weeks, is still available for sale. So if you take a look at what these pay rates that I just showed you, how this equates to your quality of life, and this is your future, this is your quality of life. This isn't mom and daddy's money. This isn't somebody else's money. This would be yours. You'd be independent. If you only make $12 an hour, you're going to be in the $25,000 a year range. Uncle Sam is going to get his cut. You got to pay your federal and state taxes. So after he gets done, you're going to have about $19,750 left. A good general rule, if you don't remember anything else from me today, is when it comes time to buy your house and your car, use 33% or a third of your income for housing as a limit, and 15% for an automobile. So if you take a look at this, the maximum cost of a house that you can afford if you make this level of income is around $75,000. That's assuming that you finance it with the bank 4.5% over a 30-year term. And automobile don't go over 15%, and you'll be okay. So this shows here that the house $75,000, this one's for $65,000, and you got a used car over here for $14,000. So I'm going to keep going. Just I'm going to kind of give you a little preface on that. We're going to jump up in salary a little bit. This is another house that was available for sale right here in Harwell. And that automobile is a new Chevy Malibu, which is available. I wish it was here in Harwell, but it's in Anderson, South Carolina. $50,000 income. There's your taxes. There's your net. Here's how much you can afford for a house. here's how much you can afford for an automobile. This is the type of house or the quality of house that you can live in. This is the quality of automobile that you can drive, making this level of income. All right, now we're up to $144,000 on the house and around $38,000 for the automobile. This assumes that you've got a salary of $75,000. Here's the taxes that you'll end up paying. And I keep talking about impact of 401k. I'll talk a little bit more about that here in just a minute. But this shows you here again, you can afford a $153,000 house, you can afford a $37,000 automobile. At that level of income, if you follow these rules. Now, I'm going to stop here. This is about as high as I'm going to go. This is $150,000 a year income, which you can make over the course of your career here in Hart County. This is how much you'll pay in taxes. This is the type of house that you can afford. And I couldn't find a $525,000 house that was available in Hart County right now. This one's $495,000. It's on a point lot right here on the lake on deep water. And a brand new 2017 Corvette. Okay, y'all hang with me just a little while longer. I'm fixing to dig in a little deeper. Okay, now, I don't know how many of you plan your week out. If you just have a little piece of paper, you try to outline out the goals and objectives that you want to achieve from one day to another, one week to another, one month or year to another. But if you do, then you are in the top 5%. 95% of people in the United States of America have no written plan. They have no written plan. So if you do that, you can beat 95% of the other people in the United States. This room of Hart County graduates, future graduates, could end up leading the world. Y'all be in the top 5% if you just have a written plan. You need to understand your strengths and weaknesses. There are certain things that I do that I am very good at. There are certain things that I try to do that I cannot do because I don't have the skills. Each of you have God-given talent. Each of you have God-given skills and abilities. So find something that you enjoy doing that aligns with your strength. You have to understand who you are. Are you more left brain analytical? Do you like to dwell in the details? Do you like to improve a process? Or are you goals oriented? Do you like working in a team or do you like working by yourself independently? Then determine the educational path that you need to achieve your goals. This isn't something that somebody else has set up for you, because who can define what your future and your success looks like but you? You're the only one that knows what success looks like for you. So determine that, and then always strive to exceed expectations, and you can't go wrong. From the first time that you have your first interview with your prospective boss until the day you retire, give that person the best that you can every day on the job. He won't be disappointed, or she won't be disappointed, and you won't either. Now, this last one right here, I might get in a little trouble, I might not invite me back, but if you live on, for every dollar you make, if you learn to live on 80 cents, you live on 80 cents, you give God, your church, your charity, whatever you want to give that other 10, you put 10 back for long-term savings into a tax-deferred account, and you cannot go wrong. You will be blessed, everything that you do will multiply. The more you try to snatch and grab and hold on to stuff, the more it's going to slip through your fingers. So giving part of what you make to somebody that's less fortunate than you are to help somebody else out will benefit you. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on this. This presentation should be available to you. There's some tools that you can use to analyze yourself to determine what your strengths and weaknesses are, left brain, right brain, whether or not you like to work in a team or not. So this is from Athens Technical College, but I believe that the high school here has other tools that you can also use. Now, we talked about putting 10% of what you make into some type of long-term savings account. If you make $25,000, if you put 10% of your money back into a 401k or an IRA, something that's offered, and the company that you work for puts in a 3% match, which is typical. You take a look at, by the time you finish your career, and the stock market grows, investments grow typically about 7%, they have since 1929, your money will grow at 7%. You can expect to get some raises over your career, averaging 3%, maybe a little bit less. But if you take a look just at a $25,000 salary, you'll have over $600,000 available by the time you get ready to retire. go on down the line, and by the time you get up to 50, 75,000, you're over $1 million in your personal retirement account, your individual retirement account. I got this outlined down here in red. Yes, you will need to leverage debt when you go to buy a house. I don't know if anybody, well, not too many people that can reach in their pocket and pull out enough money to buy a house. You'll probably have to finance a car. Beyond that, if there's anything in this world that I'm afraid of debt. I try to avoid debt. I try to stay out of debt. Debt is the number one cause of marital problems. It's contrary to popular belief, it's not anything else. Stress in your house from not being able to pay your bills will cause you more trouble over your life than anything else that you can get yourself into, except maybe drugs or alcohol. So begin saving early. Put it in tax-deferred accounts. Don't withdraw money from your long-term savings account for, you know, because you're going to sit there and you're going to watch that balance start to grow. And so be tempted to dip into that money when you need it and hard times hit, but don't do it. Leave it in there and you will not be disappointed. And continually invest in yourself. Your teachers, your parents, everybody's been telling you probably that education is the best foundation for your future success, and that is true. Without a high school diploma, I can tell you, you will not be able to get a job in Hart County. And if you do get a job in Hart County with just a high school diploma, or if you fail to get your high school diploma, that'll be the first job that gets eliminated when they can't, when a company can eliminate those jobs. Those are the first ones. So get some skills. Most companies that are being recruited to Hart County require you to have your high school diploma plus at least 2 years of technical college, which you'll be able to get right here in the College and Career Academy. And completing the technical pathway or certificate is not necessarily the end of your learning. You may be destined to go on to get a doctorate degree. It doesn't mean that you can't start with a technical college degree. My first degree was a technical college degree in computer sciences when I was fresh out of high school. And I went on to get more degrees after that, but I did start with a technical college, so I'm not telling you to do something that I didn't do. All right, many companies that are current coming here, we've had a lot of folks from Germany, Belgium, Switzerland coming here. They bring foreign direct investment. They believe in the apprenticeship approach, so they'll take the time to educate you and teach you the job once you show up. The other good thing is if you have aspirations to travel to see the rest of the world, a lot of these companies have upward mobility. As you grow with the company, you can transfer. Lyndon Beeman, which just came in, they have an operation in Barcelona, Spain. They've got one in Germany, they've got one in South Africa. So if you wanted to stay in the United States, you could do that. If you wanted to travel to Europe, South Africa, Asia, you could do that. All right, I'm getting there, I'm almost done. And I'm telling you again, one of the most important things that you can do is learn how to manage your money. Again, I've got red, avoid debt, especially credit cards. If you get out there and it's tempting, it's so easy to swipe that piece of plastic. You get yourself loaded up with $2,000, $2,500 of credit card debt, 21% interest, you'd be a good person if you can dig out from under that. And again, financial stress is the number one cause of problems in relationships. So don't overdo the toys at first. Wait until you're debt free. Then start buying your boats, your motorcycles, and stuff like that. It won't take you as long as you think. And avoid student loan debt to complete as much of your post-secondary education as you can right here before you graduate. Save and invest early. And down at the bottom here, I've listed a few books that are some of my favorites as far as how to manage your personal finances. The Millionaire Next Door is one of my favorites. Rich Dad, Poor Dad, anything by Richard Kiyosaki. And the Holy Bible. The Bible will tell you the attitude that you should have about money, because again, the more you try to snatch and grab, the more it's going to avoid you. Okay, I'm wrapping it up. Summary. You've got plenty of career opportunities right here. If you want to move away, that's your business, but you do not have to move away from Hart County to make a good income. Most Hart County industry will require you to have a high school diploma at some technical college. Know your strengths and weaknesses. And you can have an outstanding quality of life. I showed you the types of houses, the types of cars. You already know the neighborhood. You've been growing up here. You know what kind of place Hart County is. So you can have a great quality of life, a great career, if you invest in yourself first. continually invest. Invest in long-term savings and give generously to others, and you will be successful. I'm leaving my contact information up here. Shoot me an email. If I can help you individually in any way, I will try to respond. Thank you so much.